Imagine having a small army of cops and sheriffs banging on your door to evict you. That's what greeted Mary and her disabled sister Nellie at the place they've called home for most of their lives. Mary and Nellie are caught up in an ugly mortgage dispute with their bank, but they tell us they don't owe the bank a cent.
It's been shit for so many years because of the bank.
Was there an affidavit attached to this wall?
They went in there like a bulldozer and booted us straight out.
They're like predators.
If you weren't already dirty on the big banks, then cop this.
I'm showing you a copy of the writ.
Mary Green and her disabled sister Nellie, evicted from their home by six officers, two agents and one bullish financial institution.
They've got no right to do it.
No home, no bags, nowhere to go.
Do you know where you're going to go, Nellie?
And get this, Mary believes they don't owe the bank a cent.
And how do you feel now you haven't got the home?
Not nothing.
Midday, and worried neighbours gather in this peaceful cul-de-sac.
I live here, she's my next door neighbour.
We've got a tip-off that two seniors are being unfairly evicted. Here we find Mary Green and half a dozen officers occupying her house.
Hi, what's happening?
My disabled sister, they're going to bring her out, but she's really, really stressed.
Mary's sister Nellie suffered a brain aneurysm, and Mary's her full-time carer. But today, Mary can't help Nellie. They're both being kicked out.
They're court orders to say that, you know, the bank can take the house today.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, hi.
Can I just have you please just off the property for me? Thank you.
It's still my property.
It's her property.
No, I've got a writ from the Supreme Court.
May we see it?
Yeah, of course you can. Title. I don't have it on me at the moment.
Can you produce it? And we're happy to move when you produce it.
Of course.
Thank you. Great. Yes, carry on, Mary. Is this fair?
No, it's not fair.
Not fair because Mary reckons her entire mortgage was paid in full 2 weeks before the bank and New South Wales sheriffs came knocking.
Had a lawyer, talking to me on the phone, and he sort of said that they don't have the right to, and they're not allowed to put hands on me or anything.
Are you okay?
No, not really.
So my name's Sheriff's Officer Marco Petri from the Sydney City Sheriff's Office.
Yeah.
I'm executing a writ of possession today.
Okay.
I'm showing you a copy of the writ.
The sheriff may have his writ, but Mary and Nellie had this document stuck to their door. It's a notice of claim filed with the Supreme Court by a trustee who's now declared himself the home's new owner.
They attack people who are vulnerable. They absolutely wipe them out.
David Titana describes himself as a volunteer bank case officer. He's working closely with the trustee.
His role was to pay the debt out and to hold the house in trust for Mary.
I had a $30,000 mortgage, now I've got a $1,300 mortgage,
That's right, Mary's mortgage was $30,000, but it blew out to over $1.3 million. She says she was ripped off by builders doing renovations and she couldn't repay the construction loan held against the mortgage.
After that happened, I tried to get sort of assistance from the bank, but that didn't happen because I got stonewalled there.
Mary's bank is Westpac, or Westpac Your Bags, Mary and Nellie.
They allowed that debt to build. As soon as their equity was greater than Mary's, they hit the button. And today was the result of them hitting the button.
We've been fighting all year for funding with NDIS, and that's been really difficult and really time consuming. And it's sort of stopped us following on with this matter because I wasn't able to put any energy into that.
Have you enjoyed living in this house? Yeah? How do you feel about leaving? You sad? Yeah?
It's the end of the world, isn't it, Nellie?
Sorry, what's that, Mary?
It's the end of the world.
I guess you've had better jobs, have you?
Just part of the job. I'm not allowed to talk to you guys.
Can't talk to me? Yeah.
Westpac might say that the last thing they want to do is kick somebody out of their house, but clearly they disregarded an opportunity to not kick her out of her house.
Lawyer Richard Mitry says the sheriff and Westpac may have ignored important obligations when they were confronted with the trustee's statement of claim.
The sheriff had a legal obligation to bring it to the attention of the bank, and the bank then had to consider it and work out what they'll do with it. In this case, they totally disregarded it. They might as well have thrown it in the rubbish.
So what was your name, Steve?
Steve Marshall from A Current Affair. And your name is?
Robin.
Robin.
That's all you get.
No, Robin. Oh, come on, play the game, Robin.
Robin delivered me a note from Westpac, but he wasn't keen to chat about the trustee's statement of claim over Mary's home.
Robin?
No.
Was there an affidavit attached to this wall, Robin?
Can you Robin, please?
Was there an affidavit attached to this wall?
For neighbours, losing Nellie and Mary is like losing part of the furniture.
Look at that, the wheelchair's out to bring her out.
Bring her out, and, I think it's drastic overkill. They don't need, this number of officers and sheriffs to bring out a little old lady who's suffering from, multiple, ailments. Mm.
I've been here since I was, 3 years old.
Really?
And so she's been here the whole time. She's been a great neighbour. Mm-hmm. I don't understand why they're getting rid of, why they're trying to rip her.
Lots of things have gone wrong for her and me over the years, and the security in having a home to come to is pretty good.
And so Nellie was wheeled away and Mary escorted by armed officers to the waiting police car.
The police are taking us somewhere because I don't want the bank involved with the rest of our lives.
Their journey ahead, far from certain.
We just want somewhere to live where we can live in peace. Like, the only peace we have was having a roof over our head and living in this house.
Tonight, Mary is in emergency housing and Nellie is staying with relatives. Late today, Westpac sent us a statement. It says it followed a robust process, including complying with court orders and state regulation. The bank said it also offered temporary accommodation and support services. And you can read the full statement on our website.